Lean out from behind our masks. We wear masks to hide. We wear masks to protect ourselves and recently others. And we wear masks to not reveal our identities. But perhaps we wear masks to identify with others as if we were one and the same. You ain't supposed to be.
Membership card to get inside. And it's time for another unbuckled bumpy ride with your guide, the stark raving lean-atic himself. I'm Jim. Let's jump right in again. Welcome to my podcast based on my brand new book, available on Amazon, Live Life Lean, L-E-A-N. It's a year-long guide to gratitude and our daily grind. The book that combines some timeless wisdom from a whole lot of the world's wiser people with the reflections, reactions, and wisecracks of the guide's author, me. And it guides you, the reader, through the simplest system for a happy, healthy, authentic, and genuinely grateful everyday experience. I urge you to get the book. Of course I do. I wrote it. It's either at Amazon or at my website, amperage.com. AMMPURAGE. But even without it, let's make next week better than last, our next year better than the past, and get started now with today's episode of...
Okay, y'all. Today's May 15th. For a point of reference, that is, inside of our pandemic, pandemonium timeline thing that we all keep track of in our own way. Went grocery shopping this morning, and I gotta say, I was the first person, the only person that I know, but the first person that I know that was not wearing a mask in the store today. I had it hanging around my neck on its bungee leash, that same bungee leash that I've been using and wearing 7 days a week for over a damn year now. Everybody could see it, though that's not the reason why behind the leash. It's about convenience, honestly, and compliance, and respect. And honestly, that I'd rather, you know, never really rely on my own memory about having a mask or not having a mask in order to not forget it. So it's always, like, around my neck. Hanging in the front, that looks like a little black, you know, little tiny baby bib to catch my crumbs. And whip it around the back, and I'm like a supervillain with the world's tiniest little black cape. My wife is so over my mask on a leash. But that wasn't what it was about. Everybody else in the store, everybody else in that grocery store was wearing a mask. Well, why is that news? Well, the CDC just said, not 2 days ago, that you don't have to wear masks in certain circumstances like this. But there were masks on everyone. Most of them, full facial. Some of them, a few, with, you know, their nose exposed, you know, that type of thing. Okay. But it wasn't that I was being a rebel or that I was not actually paying attention. I actually was paying attention to the soundness and the science and the rules. See, as I walked into the store, there was a sign out front that said, masks, recommended for everyone's safety. Recommended? Well, I've been double vaxxed. Okay, people, whether you like it or not, whether, you know, people do or don't like it or agree, you know, listen, it's everybody's choice. It's their choice to or not to. That's not what this is about. Okay, and to be honest with you, that's not even a debate. Because since it's a choice, choice does not impact anyone else, then it's not a debate. Back to the mask in the grocery store, I was the only person. Until the very, very end of my experience. The end of this grocery store story. For the whole hour, it was about an hour that I was in there, I honestly felt less like a leader and more just like I was no longer part of some club. I'll admit, I was putting the mask on as I was walking into the store when what to my wondering eyes did appear but a sign at the front that was different than it had been all that year. Big sandwich board sign, big sandwich billboard sign. Black, you know, with the chalk writing type, and it said, masks recommended for everyone's safety. I had to pause. I mean, I had to skip a beat. I almost stumbled a step. Recommended? It had, for what seemed like forever, always read required. But no more. Now, per public guidelines, this store, by the way, this store, they brag about the fact that they're employee-owned. This store changed to follow the guidelines that said recommended. So as I approach the sliding doors to enter the store, you know, where the carts are all, you know, stacked up behind and everything, my pulse honestly started to quicken. My eyes darted around and looked, and I had my mask between my fingers, prepared to put it on my face, and I let myself walk in, all 100% bare naked-faced, nude from nose to neck. For a moment, it almost felt somewhere naughty, between like pornographic and powerful. And then I remembered what it really was. It was really just normal. Normal, human, free will. Again, after all this time. So, I shopped a little. You know, I smiled the whole time. And I'm the kind who, you know, as I go through things like this in public, I look everyone in the eye. And I smile to their face. I'm always polite. And as I'm passing by, I'm saying thank you. But no one, and I mean no one, looked me in the eye the whole 30 to 45 minutes that I made my way from the frozen chicken breasts all the way to the checkout line. Was I like invisible without my mask? Or was I just not worthy to look at because I was no longer part of the club? Earlier I mentioned that I was the only person until the very end of this experience, the end of our grocery store story. Well, you know, that was the interesting part. Because as I'm walking out, and I'm pushing my cart of all paid-for perishables and sacked-up snacks, there was a gentleman that had just walked in and grabbed an empty cart. I walked past him with my cart. We were about the same age, though he had a whole lot more hair on the top of his head than I did. Now, we passed each other, and we were just feet, literally just a few feet, behind that sign that I'd earlier referenced that said, masks recommended for everyone's safety. And he looked at me. First person other than the cashier to look me in the eye the whole time. He looked at me, and after looking at me for a brief second, he looked me up and down, and then he looked me back square in the eye, and he pulled his mask down. Now, the elastic was still hung around his ears, but now the whole mask was under his chin and jaw. I didn't say anything. I didn't even hang around long enough to see if he chuckled or smiled, or if he caught me chuckling or smiling. I just went on about my business. My business of respect. I was respecting the expressed wishes of that privately owned business. See, if that sign had said masks required for everyone's safety, like it had for the last year, regardless of what the CDC Center of Disease Control had just come out with, I'd have masked up quicker than Iron Man could. But it didn't. It said recommended. It left the choice, the responsibility, the freedom up to each individual. I respect that business. I respect every person in that store's right and their freedom to choose. And I respect that man that I saw on my way out who showed up looking just like everyone else, but then showed the world that it's all right not to. Interesting side note. Whole time I was in there walking around, you know, with the name of my business embroidered and emblazoned on the back of my jacket, I was anticipating the chance that I might be confronted. And that now, after that fact, after being confronted, potentially, I might get canceled. You know, cancel culture. Cancel culture would take a pic of me in the store and post it on social media like one of these things doesn't match kind of pic. And of course, it'd be me. Like someone was ready to just brand me a conservative as part of their cancel culture club. Yeah, like that spin on the Boy George band, the Culture Club. Call it the cancel culture club. But it never happened, though. And you know, when I got into the car, what was on my satellite radio in the car, the moment I sat inside, cranked the keys, and the radio screen came on, telling me, you know how they say the artist and the song title? It was Culture Club and the Church of the Poison Mind. True story. True details. The Church of the Poison Mind. So walking out of that mask-covered grocery store, I felt like I had just left a Church of the Poison Minds. Come on, folks. The sign said, you don't need to have that membership card to get inside. Now, more words of wisdom to wow your socks off from the Live Life Lean Guide itself. Entry number 251. It is the mark of an educated mind to be able to entertain a thought
without accepting it. Aristotle. And the guide's point of view on this? I know a gal who used to tell me, and I quote, "No, you don't understand what I'm saying, because if you understood, you'd agree." Let that one sink in, would you? So what do you think about this? Using the Live Life Lean guided journal system, what have you learned recently that's new? What have you earned that wasn't just doled out to you? Where have you added to the world that wasn't about you? And now, be grateful for all of that, reflect on it, respect it, and navigate somewhere next.
Thank you for listening. I hope you're enjoying your copy of the Live Life Lean, L-E-A-N guide, enjoying it almost as much as I did creating it. And if you don't have a copy yet, go on over to ampurage.com or Amazon and get started today experiencing the amazing power of knowing every day is literally yours to be grateful about, and you need never feel unfulfilled again. I'm Jim Hall, and until next time, good health, God bless, and now go get a little dirty learning something new, earning what's not given to you, adding to this crazy world that we share, and navigating your way to something new and next.